IT project manager course. These are modules regarding the project management, security management, quality management. Okay, and I will just introduce you with syllabus quickly, what we are covering, and then we can start with our presentation and all these things. Let me show you the topics or the TOC we are covering here. We have around 13 modules in this course, and we are going through 5 days. And we have some basic things at the start, like what is IT strategy? What is IT organization exactly? In IT organization, we are learning how to manage the staff, how to recruit them. Then we have a vendor selection and management, how to select a good vendor. Okay, for every module, I have created some presentations. And then we have a project management. It is the main topic we are covering. Then we have application management. What is product cycle? How the product development phase, testing phase, maintenance phase we work with. We have a topic on service management. Then business continuity planning. We have a risk management and a security management topic. Okay, that is more important. And information and knowledge management. How the data is managed everywhere. What is cloud technology? What is database? Everything we are going to cover. Business change management. And we have technology trends and quality management. So these are around 13 modules. We are covering around 2 to 3 modules daily. Okay, and we'll go step by step. It's completely a theoretical course, but I will try to give you some good examples. I have prepared lots of data for this. Okay, like for IT organization, I have supporting documents. Then if you are going with some vendor management, you have supporting documents which are required. Okay. So I will guide you from where you can get these documents and how to prepare these templates. Okay. And with this course, I'm going to give you a little bit knowledge of Excel also, so that you can effectively work in Excel to create your templates. Okay. So being a complete theoretical course, okay, if you think you want some break, anything you can ask. Okay. The session should be interactive. You can present your ideas, okay, about that, or you can ask me anything about these courses. So let's start. So basically, we are starting with IT organization and what is the process there, how the infrastructure should be, okay, and what are the security measures, how to provide the training, development, technical support, everything we are going to discuss. So this is the module plan, basically, like personal need of IT, what are the roles and responsibility of IT manager, how to do the sourcing, selection process, how to hire the staffs, what are the ideas behind that, how to manage the staff, career planning of the candidate, and we have training and job rotation to make people more enthusiastic in the office, like where we can do their job rotation, what is performance appraisal, and how we have to plan the staff departures so that the daily activities will not be disturbing the company. So these all complete points we are going to see in our first module. Okay, so let's start. So what are the personal needs? Okay, like suppose I say an information technology is important for today's success. Okay. And just you require to design it properly, develop and implement and maintain all the IT services properly. So different type of persons are needed in the company. Like we have some technical expertise. Okay, like IT organization requires professional with diverse technical skill, including programmers who develop the programs, system administrators who can manage the networking servers and all these things, network engineers. Okay, database administrator who work for our backup data, and naturally a cyber security experts, because nowadays security is main concern. So these are the personnel we require as a technical expertise. Apart from that, we have a project managers. Skilled project managers are essential to plan, execute, and oversee IT projects. Okay, and they make ensure that everything is completed in budget and well in time. right? These are simple things which every company requires. Then we have a business analyst. These are basically a data engineers or data analyst who work with some data analysis tools. There are many data analysis tools like Google Studio, Power BI, Microsoft Excel also, okay? They bridge the gap between the actual softwares and the organizational goals. And we have a quality assurance testers. Okay, these are the testing professionals which do the software testing whenever required. Just they measure the software for quality and all these things. Apart from, we have a support and help desk staff. Okay, and these are the end users, or you can say they help the end users for maintaining smooth operation of the systems and application. Again, data scientists and analysts, same as the business analyst, who work for the business scenario. They are working with the historical data and all these things to deliver some insights. What needed, why the sale is going down in the some areas. What should we implement so that the sale can increase? So these, in short, these are the business intelligent people who are working with the historical data and giving some drives. Then we have a cybersecurity specialist that is a much needed nowadays because the cyber threats are increasing. Okay, to protect the sensitive data, these types of personnel are needed in the company. Great. Anything in this? Everything is clear? I think it's day to day. You might be knowing all these people.
Yes.
Any doubt?
Well, yeah, sort of.
Sort of, yeah. We have all these roles. Yeah. We don't have...
Yes. Actually, technical expertise, this is a software programmer. Project managers, they are also programmers, or they are some mastery in that. Okay, you can say much senior people. Business analysts are the marketing people, or these are the digital technology peoples who are considering all the business. Quality assurance and testers, they are doing the software testing. You might be knowing there are two types of testing, a manual testing and automatic testing. Some people are expertizing software, so they do the testing with softwares also. Support and help desk are the backend people. Data scientist and analyst, again, to analyze the data, okay, to remove the bugs from the data and take the insights from the data, okay? And next, we have cybersecurity specialist, okay, to secure your data properly. So these are the personnel we generally need in the company. Next. Okay, we can see, just a minute, I'll just use the pointer. Sorry. Then nowadays, everything is on the cloud. So we require a cloud architects who are well-versed with Azure or some Amazon services. There are Google services also. Okay, suppose your data is on the clouds, then someone is there to manage that. And these are the DevOps engineers also. Then new technologies are coming like blockchains, artificial intelligence, IoT, some technology specialists. Okay, in broad manner, it's not necessary that every company has each and every person. It depends upon the company again. Then some people regarding the legal and compliance expert. Okay, what are the rules and regulation? What are the laws they have to follow? Local laws, civil laws, everything. And there are some change management specialists. Okay, these are the person who ensure smooth transition when implementing new technologies or processes within the organization. If some new project comes, how smoothly we can carry out that project. And there are some user experience, UI and UX designers, who gives the visual look to your data. And after that COVID, many companies are implementing these things, business continuity and disaster recovery specialist. If sudden thing comes, there should be some strategies to avoid that disruption. Okay. So in summary, the personnel needs of an IT organization are diverse, reflecting the complexity and dynamic nature of the technology landscape. And a well-rounded team is required to carry out all the business operations smoothly. So this was the first topic in our first module, IT personnel needs. Okay. I will share everything with you. This is normal. You might be knowing. Then we have some roles and responsibilities of IT organization. So we'll go for every person like IT manager, or we can call it a chief information officer, CIO, responsible for overall IT strategy, manage the budgeting, make the decision, and ensures IT aligns with the business goals. Okay, so he's the manager of overall. He manages all the information technology related things. Then some companies have IT director as a second foot, and some companies manage both the things by IT manager only. Oversees the specific at IT departments or project, specific to some department. He manages the team of that department and implement some policies for that department. We have system administrators. Okay, every company has a backend server. They maintain and troubleshoot the servers, networks for the smooth operation. Okay, they are very useful people for carrying out the smooth operations. Otherwise, the data may, if data stuck or any problem in the server, the whole organization will come to halt. Network engineers are there. They manage everything related to network, that routers, switches, cables, firewalls. Firewalls, these are the security softwares. Firewall is a software which allows internals, but it allows externals after verifying their personal details. Okay, so it is a security software, and it's installed in normal Windows machine also. It checks the outsiders with their username, password, and then only it allows to enter to the system. Generally, many bank people use firewalls to secure the data. Okay, it checks the incoming and outgoing pockets as per the rule. If the person is from the organization, it will allow. Otherwise, it will not allow. Then we have a database administrator. There are many database services like SQL Server, Oracle. Okay, then we have something called Microsoft Access, where Microsoft Access is not that much secure. The role of this database administrator is to allow permissions and to find out the security and integrity of the data. Okay, so data should go properly. And this DBA manages all the operations, maybe the SQL operations or anything. Then we have a security analyst. We protect from cyber threats and all these things. Software developer, they are busy in designing the code, okay, doing actual actions in the company. And they are specialists in various programming languages like Java, Python, and many things. We have a business analyst, which bridges the gap between IT and the business units. They gather the historical data and ensure IT project meets the business needs. Okay, they are experienced people who keep on studying the data and manages the things in the company. We have a help desk support staff, provide technical support to the end users. They resolve their issues and assist with software and hardware problems. Okay, suppose I have some software for my company and some problem comes, my customer calls. These people are there to help them and solve the normal problems which can be solved over the phone. Project managers are separate for every project. Okay, these are not something special. It is some senior person or some knowledgeable person from the team who can execute all the projects. He can plan the project. He can execute the actions. Okay. And he is dealing with everything in that project. Quality assurance testers, again, these are the testing people. These are checking for bugs and any issues are there in the software. Is the software giving correct result or not? Apart from, we have an IT compliance and governance specialist. Okay. Means they are as per the regulations of the company policies or not. We have a data analyst and scientist. Cloud architect to work with the data on the cloud. IT procurement specialist. Okay. These are dealing with like procedures and documentation required. Manage IT vendor relationship. They will check the vendor is good or not. They are responsible for checking the vendor's background. Okay, he's providing all the required material well in time or not. Okay, he can negotiate with them for the contracts. And then what are the softwares and hardwares required? Everything are managed by this IT procurement specialist. Web developers, they are related to company websites or company front end, which are displaying there to customers. They are designing the things. IT trainers, okay, like me, they provide the training to the employees on new IT system and technologies. IT support managers, okay, they support the team. Risk managers, if any risk comes, they protect the organization. Many things are there. We are dealing with risk management topic also. And IT consultants, okay, they are explaining various tools available for problem solving. Okay, so these all roles are contributed by each and every people of IT organization. Okay, the next part is sourcing in an IT organization. Sourcing in an IT organization, it is the process of acquiring the necessary technology resources and services to support the organization's operation and objectives. Okay, so it can be outsourcing, it can be in-house development, anything. Many companies buy people from different geographies to reduce the labor cost and all these things. Everything we will discuss it. In-house development, creating software, applications, or systems internally to meet our IT needs. This approach offers control but cannot be resource intensive. This means we can control everything, but sometimes some equipments are not required on a regular basis. Okay, so we can hire those equipments. So every time in-house development is not possible. Outsourcing, partnering with the external vendors or service providers to handle certain IT functions, such as developing some particular software for customer support. Okay, many call centers or many back offices are there who run for many companies. Infrastructure managements. Outsourcing can reduce the cost and leverage the specialized expertise. Okay, you can call a special expert from that area. Without appointing for complete whole year, we can work with them for the required period. Offshoring, extending outsourcing by collaborating with providers in different locations, often to take advantage of lower labor cost. Okay, so there are many countries who are calling the people from outside, okay, just to reduce the labor cost. Many people have the low currency values as compared to US and all these things. Many people come there and work and they are happy with those salaries or cost. Cloud computing, okay, utilizing the cloud services to access and manage IT resources like servers, storage, because they are the things which are pay as you go. When you are using, you are paying for that services. When you are not using, you are not paying for that services. They have a scalability and flexibility. Okay. Like I don't need to use multiple servers or hire the servers for complete year. Whenever I require, I can take the space on cloud and work. There are different types of clouds available as per the requirement. Okay. So you can go online in the secured environment and you can share your data online. People previously, many people were just thinking, is there will be a security or not? But it's not like that. Many services provided by Microsoft, Azure, even with Amazon, they're much more secured. Open source, okay, they are easily available. You can collaborating with open source communities to access and contribute the technology solutions. There are many open source, like you might have learned about Python. It's totally open source. Okay, you can create your own libraries, own modules, and you can work with your data. Procurement, acquiring hardware, software licenses, and IT equipment through standard purchasing process. Effective sourcing decisions depend on an IT organization's unique needs, budget constraint, and their goals. It is crucial to balance cost effectiveness, quality, and alignment with the overall IT strategy when determining the optimal source strategy. Okay, these all things again depends upon the organization to organization. Okay, so very big organization, they will prefer these things. Cloud computing nowadays, many medium-sized organizations are doing to reduce the cost of IT equipment and all these things. Okay. Then apart from that, the next topic will be what will be the selection process in an IT organization? Okay, when you are appointing any candidate as an employee, what the process you should follow? The selection process in an IT organization is a critical step just for searching the right talent. It typically involves the following stages. Resume scanning. Okay, the first thing, you ask for the resume from the candidate. HR professional review the resumes to shortlist candidate who meet the basic qualification and experience required for the particular position. Okay, there are many people, they apply for the jobs. The HR professional will just go through that. They will search for the right candidate and right qualification so that the shortlisting will be done there. After that, the second step is initial assessment. Candidate may be required to complete an online assessment. Now, you might have seen there are many job portals. They take small technical test before allowing you to apply the job. And if you're getting around 50% of mark at least in these exams, they will allow you for the application. Okay, in our India, we have many job agencies like monster.com. You might be using monster.com there also. They will take the initial assessment, and if everything is correct, if your skills are up to mark, they will allow to apply the job. Means the screening is done before applying the job only, so that there will not be multiple resumes to shortlist. Then interviews. Shortlisted candidates participate in interviews, which can include technical, general behavioral interview, and panel interviews. Okay, in interviews there are different steps. Then you have a technical evaluation. The particular expert from the company comes, ask you some challenging question, ask you to do some case studies, or just ask you to some problem solving techniques, everything. So these are the steps. Then next, the reference check. Background and reference checks may be conducted to verify the candidate's employment history. Okay, from which company he's coming, why he or she want to leave that job, then why there is a gap between two jobs, everything they consider, qualifications and the character. Offer, a formal job offer is extended to the selected candidate, which includes detail on compensation, benefits, and other terms of employment. Okay, if the employee or if the user who applied for the job is okay with everything, then starts the onboarding. Once accepted, the new employee undergoes an orientation process to familiarize themselves with the company's policies, procedures, and tools. Okay, so mostly the first 2 months are training period, and the company just familiarizing with everything. They are giving the necessary trainings to them. Then the next and last step is cultural fit. Employees evaluate whether candidate align with the company's culture and values through questions and scenarios that assess their teamwork and adaptability. These are basic steps we are following for employee, for selection process of the employee. Okay. Any doubt? Everything is clear. I'm going good.